Yesterday I talked about how I'd failed my instrument checkride, and today I just wanted to talk about one of the big fears that I always had surrounding what if I failed the checkride. And that is, if I were to fail, am I going to be able to get hired at an airline or at any aviation flying job? Is anyone going to want to hire me? Because I remember when I was a new pilot in one of my college courses, I remember one of the instructors telling us, if you're applying for a job and there's two candidates and you're both the same qualified, except one of you has a speeding ticket and one of you doesn't, most likely they're gonna interview and hire the guy who doesn't have a speeding ticket, like if they're on the fence about it. So I kind of always took that to, okay, well, if I have a checkride failure and the other guy doesn't have a checkride failure, they're probably more likely gonna interview and then hire him. But I've found throughout the years that's not necessarily the case, because I did fail a checkride and I was still able to get interviews and I was still able to get hired. But I think it's because I was able to talk about it in the interview, because I did get asked on both interviews, have you failed a checkride? So if you get asked that question and you answer it in a way that doesn't make anybody look good, probably not the best idea. For example, if they'd asked me that and I'd said, yeah, I failed my instrument checkride, but it was the worst weather, I probably shouldn't have gone flying, it was really bumpy, and the examiner was pretty rude the whole time, and he was vectoring me around in unrealistic vectors, which gave me situational, I lost my situational awareness. You know, if you talk about it like that, it's you're not gonna get the job. But if you talk about it like, you know, I did fail my checkride, and, you know, tell them the story like I did yesterday, tell them what happened in a good way. And then after you're done telling the story of what happened, then explain something like, even though I'm not happy that I failed the checkride, I am grateful for the experience, because it did allow me to realize that I need to prep a little bit more, not just in the books, but also mentally. And I need to remind myself that, you know, I know what it is that I'm doing, and I've studied all the stuff that I need to study. Not only have I become a better pilot, but I've also become a better person because I failed that instrument checkride. So if you say something along the lines of that, and it needs to be a real reason of really, how have you become better because of it? If you can't think of something, there is a good reason there, because if you have continued on in aviation, you've pushed past that failure, you know, and you have become better somehow. So dig deep and think of what it is and be ready to talk about it in an interview.